नमस्ते कैशिया, इट्स अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग स्टोरी फ्रॉम महाभारत विच आई थॉट आई विल शेयर टुडे। आफ्टर द वॉर इज ऑलमोस्ट ओवर एंड पांडवाज हैव वन, अर्जुन हैज अ रिलैक्स फीलिंग एंड ही थिंक्स ही हैज अचीव समथिंग विच वॉज कंसिडर्ड टू बी इम्पॉसिबल, विनिंग ओवर द कौरवास। There's a lot of pride in him, and then he sort of boasts about how the victory was achieved. Throughout, his sarathi, which is none other than Lord Krishna, keeps smiling. And finally, Arjun says, "You know, Krishna, please get down of the chariot. I need to get down." Krishna very smilingly says, "You first." He says, "Krishna, you go first." He said, "No, plus you first get out of the chariot. And after you get out of the chariot, put down your, the bow and the arrows. What are the famous kandibam?" And he says, "Wait." And Arjun doesn't understand, but he always knows that Lord Krishna has some meaning behind it. And then with reluctance, he gets down off the chariot. And as he gets down off the chariot, the flag on top of the chariot, which is nothing but Lord Hanuman himself, that flag disappears. And the moment it disappears, Lord Krishna steps down off the chariot. And then the chariot is burnt to flames. Arjuna is shell-shocked, so are the other Pandavas. He really doesn't know what has happened. And then he asks Lord Krishna, "What has happened? Why did my chariot burn?" Krishna gives him a smile and then says, "I have been protecting this chariot from burning for the last 18 days of the war. Your chariot was attacked by Dronacharya, by Karna, by so many people with the divine weapons. Each of the weapon would have destroyed you and maybe the chariot along with it. And I was there protecting you at all the time. And if I had got off before you from the chariot, you would have been consumed by the flames. Such is the divine power and the Brahmastras and everything else that people threw at you, which I have shielded, which is charged with the chariot, and it was just waiting for me to get off." And then literally Arjuna gives him a hug and cries, "What a folly for me to think that I am the one who has achieved all this." Krishna, as usual, pats him on the back, gives him a smile, and they all walk off. There is a similarity between this story and our own lives. There is a famous saying in Tamil, "Avan Andri Anuvum Asayadu." Without his permission, even an atom cannot move in this universe. Yet, in our own egoistic state, we continue to believe that I did this, I did that, I achieved this, I did this for my master, or I did this for my guru, and things like that. Imagine the role of Krishna with Arjuna. At least he was friendly enough to tell him at the end how he protected him. In the case of our masters, they silently do all this to ensure that your passage from here into the ultimate goal is made as safe as possible. At every turn, at every challenge that you have faced, you get some kind of a support. I had mentioned this earlier also. Even in my life, I have gone through several challenging situations. And each time I have seen that there was some kind of a helping hand in some way. Not that master physically comes and solves these things for you. It's again not out of blind faith or a blind belief that he will do it. But as Lord Krishna said, every sincere abhyasi has his protection. The same is true for every sincere abhyasi. You have master's protection. And please bear in mind, our role is only to do the efforts. We just cannot even for one single second think that I have achieved. The more you grow in the spiritual system, the ego gets subtler and subtler and subtler. To the extent that you have such a subtle ego, which is one of the most powerful, yet you think you are achieving. And as long as I is there, as they say, he can't really be there. The lane of lover is so narrow, you have space only for one. We have to get into his heart and ensure that there is a very implicit acceptance that at every stage of my life, not even one single second, anything that happens can happen on my own. When that surrender truly happens at a level of the heart, then Master finally accepts that yes, here is a person who has made his ego as the disciple's ego, then the job is truly done. Till then, we at any point of time can have the same case which happened to the chariot of Arjun. What if Master is not there with us for a second? Imagine the plight. It's time that we understood the importance of this story and understood the importance of the Guru and have this implicit surrender and obedience that I am nothing without him. I am nothing unless he is there with me all the time. When that happens, not out of a theoretical framework, but it happens out of a practical experience, then the job is done. Think about it, feel about it. I wish you the very best. Thank you.